Glad to have you with us in the studio. I'm Reese Davis, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 pregame show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
We haven't even kicked off yet, and these fans are already going crazy for the Tostitas Fiesta Bowl here in Glendale, Arizona. And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players.
Looks like a GoDaddy Bowl to me.
He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. They'll spread the field with five wide.
Come on already.
Second down. And down he goes, the 37-yard line. So they'll pick up a first down there on a 4-yard completion.
I think they were expecting a run on that play, Brad, and allow the quarterback to throw for just enough yards to get the first down.
Strike and he drops it. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 37. He's taken down at about the 39-yard line.
Baby, let's go.
He made the catch, but he didn't get the first down.
Yeah, right now, the way this defense is swarming, there's just no room for him to get upfield for the first down.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. And he's tackled at the 22. Quarterback leads the team out on the field for the first drive.
Slow and steady. Avoid the 9 interceptions.
From their own 29-yard line, second down. Tackled at about the 31. They're packed in tight on the line.
Not going to pull anybody away, apparently. There it is. All right, let's go.
At about the 45.
He's going to get some congratulations for that nice display of running. Normally, his job is to block.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 45.
Next time he should just throw it away out of bounds. When you can move the ball downfield in big chunks like that, you've got the defense right where you want.
From the 41-yard line, first down.
Oh, he's slow. Brat.
There was simply no daylight on that play. The defender came in and dropped the hammer.
All day. All day. You're gonna end up kicking a field goal out of all this. Nope, got it.
Tackle made at the 12-yard line.
Here's the true test of a quarterback at any level. Can they make a good throw under pressure when one or two or three guys are coming right at him? I think this young passer has proven that, yes, he can.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. And he's tackled after positive yardage.
Jeez, oh Pete.
Straight run and he's brought down in the backfield. It was the defensive lineman that got a hold of him there.
You're not going to break many tackles when this guy gets his hands on you.
Play 13 of the current drive.
Let's go.
To the 20, and he's taken down at the 27. The Miners are right where they want to be early in this one.
Well, this is what their coach talked about, getting off to a great start. The defense did their job, and it's nice to see the offense move the ball down the field and also get some points on the board.
You never like to have to play from behind, but a deficit this manageable shouldn't be in the front of their mind. They just need to go out there and play. Fires out to his receiver.
Oh,
and he's
wow.
Taken down at about the 33-yard line. Here on second down.
Derrick Henry over here. Holy smokes.
And he shoved out of bounds right around the 14-yard line.
That was a good-looking play, and it sort of caught the defense off guard.
Jesus.
He scrambled. They'll make the sack.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
From the 20-yard line, second down.
Got him.
He's going to get sacked. Down he goes again.
If they keep putting pressure on him like this, he might start to look to get rid of the ball quicker, which could very possibly lead to turnovers.
After one, this game's still pretty close. The Miners with a touchdown lead. Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. Five wide.
Uh-oh. No. What are we doing here? Oh, Jesus. Thank you. Thank you for the help.
Woo!
We are UTEP. I have never seen that. Wow.
Looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. Good move. He's going to call for a fair catch. Quarter down. I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. Texas El Paso is up four. Pulls down the catch and he's got room here. Down around the 39-yard line.
You know, if you use him in this offense the right way, it's almost like you have an extra wide receiver. He's that good.
From their own 39-yard line, it's first down. They'll bring him down around the 37-yard line.
Really?
To go. Ball on the 39. The Miners running back down on the sideline. He was injured earlier. He means a lot to this offense, but I think he's going to be able to come back in. Looks like
no. Oh my. Okay.
He's got his man. He's tackled around the 45-yard line.
Yes. We need him back.
Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Kind of surprising here that they didn't elect to punt. I don't agree with this call.
And that's why you're not coaching, bud.
Big play and on fourth down to boot. The entire offense looked in sync on that play.
Texas El Paso is up by four. Here comes the defense, and he tackles him hard at the 48-yard line.
Man, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see. Is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
They find themselves in a hole here after that sack at second and long.
God. That's going to be blown up. Yup.
Play action. Swings it out there incomplete. Good awareness defensively that time by the linebacker.
Not only that, but as you saw, he also made a very athletic move to get to the ball.
This is the eighth play of this drive.
Damn, Daddy.
From the 30-yard line, first down. Got him in the screenplay. And down he goes at the 21-yard line.
That brings up second and one.
This is the 10th play of this drive.
Sometimes the defense does everything right, and they still lose. That time they had tight coverage, which left no options other than for the quarterback to take off.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Texas El Paso holds a four-point lead. Fakes to the back.
No, to get it. Dive on it. Let's go. Let's go.
So an 11 play, 75-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. Ramos gets set to kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. About the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it.
Uh-oh. Oh.
He's to the 40. He finally goes down at the 49. He carried that one for a huge gain.
You know what? You can see the ball carrier showcase his speed. Once he got into the open field, he just turned on the jets and flew.
First and 10. Ball on the 49-yard line.
Let's go! Green 19! Behind green! All
right, bro.
Get
chill.
To about the 47-yard line.
Came with the blitz, and a quarterback showed tremendous poise by making a good read and delivered a nice ball to the open man.
Here we go, here we go, here we go.
post ball him back and got his man. Tackle around the 24-yard line.
They've not tried throwing deep yet. We'll be a little more aggressive here.
From the 24-yard line, first down. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers.
Red, two, go.
Fires complete over the middle. A huge play, and now they're in a great position to score.
Well, the quarterback's able to find a soft spot in the defense, and he threw an accurate ball for a solid pickup. Because he got away with throwing what should have been an interception.
Should have been.
At the eight. It's second down.
Perfect timing to jar the ball loose and not pick up the penalty. That was a solid play.
That makes it third and goal.
It's the ninth play of the drive. Tailback on the screen, and he's tackled at the 14. Fourth down. So the kicking team is on the field. They'll try for three. And they can make this a one possession game with this kick right here.
You dirty dog.
It up and he got it. Northern Illinois gets set to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20, at the corner, at the 30, and he's tackled at the 34-yard line. UTEP's offense is just clicking on all cylinders, Herbie, right now. It's everything they planned for, and it's all working.
Everything is coming together for this offense. They seem to be getting better with each series. And, you know, this game started where this team was, you know, they wondered if they were going to be able to move the ball against this defense. And I think right now, I think they seem to, as I said earlier, they seem to be growing with their confidence with each possession.
Throws it in a hurry. He's knocked out.
Clutch freaking block.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 47. Texas El Paso up by 8. That was made out of the 36-yard line. UTEP's going to use their first time out of the half here.
Definitely in field range. Not gonna force anything.
Excellent open field tackle.
As they force it,
and it's almost picked off.
Okay.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 22-yard line. And he's taken down around the 14-yard line. The Miners, they're going to have to call their third and final timeout.
Mm-hmm.
He's scrambling.
You why?
Folks, that's the end of the first half, and this game's getting interesting. 14-6, UTEP. All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here.
He sends this one deep.
Short kick, and he'll fair catch this one. This offense has found the end zone on their last two drives, and they're coming out on this one trying to do much of the same.
Texas El Paso is up by 8.
Throws quickly, and it's almost intercepted.
He got caught up, and definitely.
Catches it, and he's looking for more. Knocked out of bounds. Right around the 50. From midfield, it's first down.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Catches it deep, immediately tackled behind the line. 3-yard loss there.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 40. He heaves it deep. Nice grab on the play. Down, right around the 14-yard line. Texas El Paso holds an 8-point advantage. Complete brought down, nothing doing.
That makes it second and 10.
From the 14-yard line, second down.
Blitzing so hard.
And that'll be the second time that he found the quarterback today.
Third down.
Here's the 8th play of the series. He steps out at the 14-yard line. It's fourth down. They'll line it up for the field goal. Kicks up, and they tack on 3 points. Ramos has the ball all teed up, and he's ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
Everywhere we go in college football, everybody's got a T-shirt that says finish, finish. Whether that means finish the game or finish the drive. Right now, this offense is moving the ball. It's not finishing the drive. They've got to execute better down closer to the opponent's territory.
They'll run it.
Oh! Jesus!
31-yard line. It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks.
Ready! 180! 180!
complete. Yeah, beat, bro. Beat bad.
Inside the 30 for the 10. He's all the way home. Touchdown.
Nice.
And he adds the extra point. Northern Illinois is ready to kick it away. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. Across the 30. Across midfield.
Can't wait to see the clipping.
At the 43-yard line.
The Huskies have really surprised everybody in this football game.
They have not been intimidated at all, which is great to see. The attitude and effort of this team has put them in a position where they got a shot to win this game here in the second half.
They're ready to begin another drive.
Texas El Paso is up four. Now he's scrambling. Here they come, heading for the corner. He goes out of bounds.
Yikes.
Right around the 30. It's first and 10. Ball on the 30.
Down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Defense and their short yardage package.
Oh!
Gets about a yard on the play. One.
You're a jerk.
At the 6-yard line, the offense couldn't get those linemen blocked, and they'll lose yards.
Well, here, the defensive lineman did a great job at sealing up the hole at the line of scrimmage.
Well, let's see what they do here. It's third and goal from the 6.
Kick is up, and it sails through the uprights.
And you got to think they're pretty happy with holding them to a field goal right there.
And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. He breaks a second tackle. He's pushed out of bounds. Right around the 36-yard line.
Man, both offenses here in this third quarter have been on fire. Time for the defense to step to the forefront a little bit.
Makes you wonder which of these defenses has the ability to come up and make a stop. It could be one of those games where whichever defense comes up with that stop could be the team that wins the game.
They'll bring him down at the 28-yard line.
Very solid gain through the air. I'm impressed with the poise of this quarterback and the ability of the receiver to keep his concentration and get his hands on the football.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Great pressure on the quarterback forced that incompletion.
Boy, they really pounded him on that throw.
First down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. Touchdown, NIU. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He's
splits the uprights with the extra point. Richardson is lined up to kick this one off. Excellent kick. He's to the 20.
Ooh, we might have it. We might have it. Get away from me, kicker. Get away from me. Oh, no! Let's go! Touchdown! Touchdown!
When you combine that with the speed that he has, you've got somebody who can make these kinds of breathtaking plays.
He makes the PAT.
Fireworks in this third quarter here. Need to settle it down in the fourth.
He really got a hold of that kick. He's to the 20.
Oh, I thought they were going to return the favor.
The 32. The Huskies having everything going their way right now. They have put up 20 straight points on the board. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing.
Job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
Second and 11 coming up now. Ball on their own 31.
Black five, black.
He's to the 40. He makes his way to about the 48. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. He's going to try and scramble, and he hits him hard at the 49-yard line. So with one quarter remaining, UTEP leads it 27-20 into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action.
Let's go, Stan! Make some noise! Green nine, green nine!
Got him.
And he's going to be sacked.
The defenders played the snap count perfectly. He found the path into the backfield and didn't let the quarterback get away.
Third and long now after the sack.
Trailing, time's a factor. Why not make your offense more of a vertical threat instead of running?
It looks like they're going to go after this punt. And he's hammered down.
Not great, but not bad either. As long as your main priorities are not turning the ball over and establishing solid field position, then you're headed in the right direction.
A score here might effectively end this one. Texas El Paso is up by a touchdown. Makes the catch, and look out. He's taken down at the 35. Second down and five. Ball on the 35. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Hankins picks up about 4 yards on the play. They stack the line of scrimmage here. Let's see who's got the stronger lineman. From their own 43-yard line, first down. Yeah.
kids make on a regular basis. And if you can make enough of them in college, probably going to get a chance to play at the next level.
Come on, Daddy.
And they make the stop at the 46-yard line. First and 10.
One more first down might be it.
And he's tackled at the 45-yard line. A little more than 2 minutes to go in the fourth quarter.
There it is.
He makes his way out to about the 35. So
and we're in field goal range. Yep, Daddy.
Just a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
And this is the eighth play of the drive. Taken down at the 32-yard line. The back gets three on the carry.
And he took a shot on that play, Brad. It looks like his head might be still ringing a little bit.
Second and eight coming up here. Ball on the 32-yard line. Tackle made right around the 34.
Sometimes a play is not going to work for whatever reason. Doesn't mean you throw the play away. You just need to execute better next time.
And this is the 10th play of the drive.
Eagle! Eagle!
Hands off to the left, and they wrestle him down behind the line.
No longer know if I'm in field goal range or not. No. No, we are not. And take the delay of game.
It's fourth down. The ball in the corner. Offense is getting set to go for it. Here's the call from the referee.
Delayed game. Offense.
He wasn't. Oh,
UTEP
wait. Yeah,
staff just devastated when you look at him over on the sideline after that turnover.
Well, everything seemed to be falling into place for them with a chance to win the game and then to turn it over like this. Oh, my gosh. What a nightmare.
Fourth and 15 after the penalty.
Oh. No!
Bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback.
Oh, my God.
This is a pretty crucial series right here. With things being so tight, your best players have to step it up on both sides of the ball. A little over a minute in the game.
Come on.
There's a
no!
Complete. Knocked out of bounds. Right around the 24-yard line.
Second and six. When did that happen? Oh, okay.
Second down and six. Ball on the 24-yard line. He sails it long. Can't pull it in. It looks like they're going to blitz. sacked for a loss. Spikes the ball. Third and long here, and they hope to convert another one and keep this drive going.
Oh, that was unexpected.
He makes it to the 32-yard line. So a running play on third and long nets them very little yardage.
Now, you can't do that when you're losing a ball game. Now's the time to take your shots downfield.
This is their last chance. They need a big play here. You can talk about offense all you want, and they were good today, but the defense was better. They come up with a play of the day, and that'll lead to the victory. The whistle hasn't sounded yet. They still have to snap the ball and make sure they don't make any mistakes. We have less than a minute to go. The offense lining up in a victory formation, and he takes a knee.
You just can't take anybody on your schedule for granted. Not even the biggest underdog. I'm sure they won't make that mistake again. UTEP found themselves in a far stiffer fight than anybody imagined. If they didn't think much of these guys before the game,
bet me over last time.
Of respect for them now.
Yeah, he only beat that by a little bit. Consistent. See if we're in coaching changes. I don't care. Everybody's tied the same. No. You dirty dog. Don't like you. Fudge. Our whole quarterback room is leaving. No! You were gonna be a starter! I need. Not you, but I'm not gonna complain. I need that quarterback so bad. What are we doing here? Of course. Of course we're behind. Why wouldn't we be behind? These two quarterbacks. I'm nervous. Come on. Give me one. Oh, we got three? Huh. We had eight kids commit, and three of them are quarterbacks. Start with the one athlete we have. Oh my God. Speed though. Be alright, wide receiver, alright, running back. So let's see what we got. What? That's a tall boy. Oh, it's, oh my god. Alright, we're good. We didn't look at everybody. Alright, so we looked. Ooh, some solid tight ends. We'll be alright next year. About to get burnt in the passing game. So bad. Do we need to cut anybody? Three. I don't want to do that. LSU, whoa, daddy. Northwestern or Illinois? We're going to Northwestern. God. Forgot I did that. The ACC? Yeah, I can go to the ACC. Looks good to me, Daddy. Alright. Let's get all our coaching trees done. What are we gonna? Nope. Team ends. That's the button. Tight end, kicker, defensive tackle. Don't need a whole lot. Anybody hit? All right. be. Oh. Make this a neutral. So you can go for three more. I think we'll put our scrambler in a couple shotgun formations. Our offense improved a little bit, not so much our defense. Yeah. Bum 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 bum.
Hi everybody, Reese Davis with you, bringing you the EA Sports NCAA Football
14
pregame show
football.
Presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites.
Both teams have sent their special teams out of the field, and we're ready for the opening kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. Signals for a fair catch. UTEP's coaching staff so confident they know they've got a guy that's one of the best running backs in the country and that they can just play their game and not worry about the fact they're on the road.
Well, Brett, his big play ability not only can give you big chunks of yards on the road, but more importantly, it can quiet this atmosphere and allow the quarterback in this offense just getting back and just being able to run and be able to communicate. And I think that's a big challenge for this team. So look for his big play ability to maybe even out the atmosphere and give this offense a chance to
not the best start in the world, but we'll see.
Maybe two on the carry. Second and eight coming up here. Ball on the 27. Throws in a hurry. Catches it, and he's looking for more. They'll bring him down around the 42-yard line.
Man, that was an impressive-looking play. When you can slice apart a defense like that, it puts a seed of doubt in their minds.
Number three comes in.
Oh my God, this tight end's gonna go for Heisman.
We've got a change at the quarterback position. You gotta wonder how that's gonna affect this offense. I would think the offensive coordinator and the head coach are just gonna try to ease him into this game at the beginning. First and 10, ball on the 22. Setting up play action.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. Quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
One left and he's taken down in the backfield.
That brings us third and 10.
Third and 10 coming up. Ball on the 22-yard line. Play action. Decides to tuck it in, and he's got space. He's out of bounds, just outside.
Put it in your other hand.
Hawthorne's the guy everyone has their eyes on right now, Kirk, and he comes with a lot of expectations. Time will only tell if he's the new hope or if he's all hype. The short yardage defense here. Touchdown, UTEP.
So tight, every play seemed to be of the utmost importance.
Excellent kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Quick strike and he drops it. From their own 25-yard line. Second down. Give to the tailback, and he's met in the backfield.
It's never good for a back's confidence to get tackled for a loss. But this guy knows that he's got to just keep at it, and the holes will start to open up.
I don't know where the screen is.
Might not be able to get the pass off.
Oh, my God.
Some daylight.
There's got to be a flag
inside
somewhere.
The 30, the 10, tackled inside the 5-yard line. There's a flag down.
Thank you.
This most likely is going to be on the defense.
Thank you. Yeah, we're
lined up for another
that.
Third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
So with the penalty, they've got third and a mile. Still completed it. Tackle made around the 24-yard line.
Unreal!
The defense would have liked to have prevented such a big gain, but the important thing is that they held and brought up fourth down.
Johnson to punt. Brought down at the 42-yard line. UTEP staff was talking all week long that this offense wanted to get off to a strong start, and they have.
They have. They talked about building that momentum early in the game and then trying to be able to hold on into the second half. Boy, they've gotten off to a great start so far.
Let's find out if the defense has made any adjustments after giving up a touchdown on that last drive.
I think the defense right now is just sitting back on their heels. They're allowing the offense to kind of dictate things to them. And one thing is that any defensive coordinator would tell you in the country, you have to be the one trying to dictate things to the offense. So change it up. Try something different. If it's not working, you can't continue to sit back on your heels.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. Tackled after a decent run up the gut. That makes it second and 6. Texas El Paso is up 7. Robinson off the fake.
Oh, daddy.
And he's taken down at the 40-yard line. They need about 3 yards
bum,
to get
bum,
the first
bum,
down
bum,
here on
bum,
third
bum,
down.
Bum, 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 bum.
Somebody jumped early down there.
Bruh.
They'll give this one another try after the flag.
And on third down, too. Third down. That's when you don't want those kind of things to happen.
Around the 34-yard line. A nice looking play that time.
Well, the defense was blitzing here, and again, great recognition by the quarterback to find the hot receiver.
Robinson. It's first and 10. Ball on the 34-yard line. Sacked on play action.
You know, this defensive end has tremendous athletic ability and speed. He also has size to go with it. When you combine all those skills, it's no wonder he's getting after this quarterback.
And down he goes, the 39-yard line. Hankins gains around 3 yards on the run.
That makes it 30-15.
Down, and they need to get it to the 24. Texas El Paso is up a score. He's scrambling. Now he's going to run and watch out. Heading for the corner, and he shoved out of bounds right around the 24-yard line. This is the eighth play of the drive.
Alert, alert. Lion, lion.
They try him again, and this time they've got him in the backfield. They try to counter Trey there, but the defense read it nicely.
It's amazing the read and recognition skills of these linebackers. They just always seem to have a beat on the play.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 24. Run, and he's brought down.
That's good for a gain of 4 yards. That'll bring up third and 6.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Complete. He's got room. The 10. Touchdown.
Let's go, baby.
Touchdown!
Receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
He makes the PAT. A 10-play, 64-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
So our score, 14-0. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They need to show a little giddy up now, because if they don't start eating into this deficit, they could easily fall out of the game. Caught him, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. Taken back 3 yards.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
From their own 22-yard line, it's second down. Quick throw, incomplete, blocked his receiver. He's unable to hit his receiver. He overthrew it.
Yeah, and that's a throw he should make every single time.
Check three, check three, check three. Get high, man, get up. Let's go.
Black five, black five. Red seven, red seven.
Big. And they got it.
I think that one's on the offensive line. They've got to do a better job of holding their blocks, or else this quarterback's going to be pulling turf out of his face mask all game.
That'll bring it into the first quarter of action. The Miners lead it by 2 touchdowns. And we're back for more action here in quarter number 2. Eldridge is the deep man awaiting the return. He drops it. That was a great hit. He wasn't getting away from that one.
Did he drop it? No. Not even close, Kirk.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. Quick release. Oh, had it knocked down.
You know, that actually might have been a break for the offense.
Yeah,
sometimes
no fucking shit.
Passes can linger in the air and get picked off.
From the 47-yard line. Second down. the 44-yard line. Scrambling.
I should have ran that.
But he can't bring it in.
I'm not so sure he made the best decision.
No, he did not.
That was a pretty tight area he was trying to throw that one into.
So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. This is a very questionable play call here. I'm not sure I agree with it. He's under pressure. Can't wrap him up. And he can't get the pass off, and he's sacked. They'll turn the ball over on down.
Questionable play calling there by the coaching staff. It's way too early in the game to be going for it on fourth down. I would have punted the ball in that situation.
Well, now let's just see how much this will come back to haunt them. It's first down going the other way. And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
From the 34-yard line.
What?
It's second down. They'll line up with five wide receivers. And they make the stop at the 31-yard line.
Gaining 3 yards. That makes it third and three.
In the shotgun and five wide outs. Receivers got it on the screen. Inside the 10, steps out of bounds around the 11-yard line.
Great touch by the quarterback, floating that one right into his hands. That takes some skill.
From the 11-yard line, first down.
Here we go.
Brought down around the 3-yard line.
Makes it second and two.
Got to be careful of a pass play with this defense. Touchdown, Wildcats. Wait a second. They put the points on the board, but they might have to take them down. And that halfback took it in for the score.
Yep, he punched that in from a short distance. He had great blocking up front on that play.
So they had their chances to stop him, but in the end, he comes up with a big play. And he converts the extra point. Kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. UTEP's running ability is what we've been talking about and looking at all week long, and that's what we thought would be on full display. But it's been the air game, Kirk.
Yeah, it's an interesting move here, Brad. For a team with a star in the backfield, I'd expect them to try to establish the ground game a little bit more. But still early in this game, we're seeing them following this trend to see if it continues here in the second half.
Texas El Paso is up by a touchdown. Caught, and he's brought down quickly.
I like that they're completing these underneath routes, because pretty soon the defense is going to start to cheat up. That's when the quarterback will have his chance to go over the top for the big play.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Gain of 5 yards. That makes it first and 10.
Second and six. Ball on the 41. And he's tackled at the 45. Throws, falling back and finds his man. Perry gains 4 yards on that reception. Comes the pressure
on a dime.
He's taken down around the 38-yard line.
Number 23.
First and 10. Ball on the 38. Left and can't get back to the line of scrimmage.
By the time the running back here got the football, he's looking up and he's got a couple defensive linemen closing in on him because they were able to slip off of their blocks. Really, there's nothing he could do at all there. That was more of a miscommunication and just getting overmatched up front by the offensive line.
Texas El Paso up 7 points. He's under some heat.
It's a bad play overall by the
offensive line.
Quarterback's doing everything
apart.
He can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Now he tries to buy some time. He sails it long. Tipped away.
He took a shot downfield going for the big play, but the defender did a great job to follow it and then break it up.
It looks like they're going to go after this punt.
Shit.
Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. I'm sure that touchdown in their last possession's given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field.
And it was a really nice drive, too, Brad. The quarterback got into a nice rhythm and did a good job of picking apart the defense.
Here's the give. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line.
Hooper Price.
Second and 10. Ball on the 20.
Oh, I don't know if he got me or not.
Slings it out there incomplete.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
They'll bring him down at the 30. The Miners will use their first time out of the half.
It was still a quality run. I like the fight the offense showed in earning those yards.
They look like they've got the block on, and this offensive line's got to give him some time. He makes it out to maybe the 36-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Texas El Paso is up 7. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. He's tackled at the 41.
Joseph brings him down on the 41-yard line. That will make it 2nd and 4.
Got an opening. Nice run up the middle. From their own 48-yard line, it's first down.
You know, at that point, I think, Brad, the quarterback's just better off just taking a sack. You have to be very careful as you're feeling pressure to throw the ball just to throw the ball. If you feel like you're not going to be able to make the play and the defense got you, just give up on that play and get ready for the next down.
Made around the 35-yard line.
Well, that's a big-time play there. And as a quarterback, you're willing to take certain chances with certain wide receivers. You're not going to put the ball into coverage like that very often. But if you have confidence and trust, and you've worked out a lot with that wide receiver, you know what his abilities are, and you know that you have confidence that he's going to be able to come down, regardless of putting it up in traffic, you're willing to take that chance. And that time, that's exactly what we saw.
From the 36-yard line, second down.
Terrific coverage, and when you clog up passing lanes like that, you could force a quarterback to make some poor decisions. Almost got themselves a turnover, too.
Texas El Paso is up a score. On play action under heavy pressure.
Oh, Fryer for Heisman. This man is doing it all for his team.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. On the run. He's got the corner. And now the ball is loose. And the ball bounces out of bounds. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
This quarterback.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The defense really shut these guys down the last time they had the ball. And he just gets rid of it.
Even though they didn't sack him, the pressure was still enough to force a bad pass. If you can get in there and disrupt the pocket, then the quarterback is going to have a tougher time getting the ball to his playmakers.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. Gets rid of this one.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
Got it. And he goes down quickly.
They shut that drive down pretty emphatically. That's something to build on.
UTEP's going to have to use their second time out of the half. Johnson is the punter. Room around the corner, and he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
This offensive coordinator's got to be feeling so good about the execution that he's seeing from his quarterback and his wide receiver. Because, again, they put so much time in trying to put a plan together. And to be able to see that actually come into play makes you feel pretty good as a play caller.
The Miners using their third and last timeout. From the 44-yard line. First down. One more play now before we hit halftime, so they'll most likely throw one towards the end zone here. Throws it deep.
This man.
We're halfway through, and it's been a good one. 21-7, UTEP. All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. UTEP's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers. The way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage, I think it's giving them confidence. It's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Hands it to the back. And he's leveled to the 37-yard line. From their own 37-yard line. First down. And he shoved out of bounds at about the 37-yard line. That makes it second. makes the catch and look out. That's a great tackle.
We're expecting that this season. It's going to be rough when we get to Ohio State.
On one side of the ball that time. And it looks to me like the defense was in a little state of confusion. Let's see if they can pull themselves together.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 35. Throws it to the outside. Wide open, but it falls incomplete.
Number 18 was the intended receiver on the play. Third down.
So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. They'll spread the field with five wide.
Got him.
Oh!
Brad, I thought the quarterback put the ball there where it could have been caught. The receiver's got to do a better job of fighting for the football. When that ball is up in the air and it's between a defender and a receiver, I think the receiver's got to show more effort and a willingness to fight for the football. The safety just knocked that ball away from him.
It's up, looks long enough, and it's good. Northwestern ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. He makes it to the 18-yard line. Northwestern's really excited to watch this guy grow with this defense. That was his first tackle, but I guarantee you, he's got hundreds more coming. So you wonder what kind of excitement we'll see this time around. This is second and long. Quick pass, tight end, and he wasn't ready for it.
Number 87 was the intended receiver on the play. That'll bring up third and long. Number 3 is in the quarterback.
Dumps it complete over the middle. And they make the stop at the 9-yard line. Sloan to punt. Gets it away. It's low. And down he goes to the 38-yard line. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now.
Does there?
They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Tackled after a decent pickup.
That brings him second and five.
From the 33-yard line, second down. We've got a second and nine here. Ball on the 27-yard line. He makes his way to about the 18.
Dude, I just cannot get a tackle animation going.
First and 10. Ball on the 15-yard line. Concentration to pull it in.
And now he's got room to run.
And he hits the PAT. A 7-play, 38-yard drive. And that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. That can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. And on the corner. He gets out to about the 22-yard line. The Miners
fans have got to be going crazy. It looked like they had this one in hand or
yeah, no shit.
It out of reach.
No shit, Brad.
This is a tough game for the fans to watch because their team was so dominant early in the game, and now they've just gone cold, and they've allowed the opponent to get right back into this game. They better find something here to be able to try to get out of here with a win.
Texas El Paso is up by 4. Taken down at the 21-yard line.
This offensive line is garbage.
The pitch, and he's got some room. Got the corner. He's knocked out of bounds around the 31-yard line. Run up the middle. First down. Three down. Let's go. Caught, and this is going to be a first down. Tackle at the 48-yard line. Tackles around the 28-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 28. And he carries the ball for a nice game. This is the 8th play of the drive. Texas El Paso holds a 4-point lead. Throws it into coverage and it's intercepted. And he tackles him hard at the 27-yard line.
That is exactly the kind of play you want to see from a safety. He needs to be able to read the play and then make the interception.
From their own 27-yard line, it's first down. Up the middle for a nice game. They'll line up with 5 wide receivers. 40. He makes his way to about the 48. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 48-yard line. And he makes it out to about the 47-yard line.
Gain of one on the play. That brings up second and 9.
The quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Slides down. That's 3 down and 1 to go. The Miners lead it by 4. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter.
Let's go, Stan, make some noise.
Hand off inside. That's a huge, huge stop here in the fourth quarter. They've got the lead. They're going to get the football back, but there's still a lot of ball left.
Oh, my.
And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. He throws.
Fake screen.
Almost intercepted. And they'll fail on fourth down. Quarterback couldn't maintain possession on their last drive. Let's see what he does here.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
He's tackled around the 44-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of 3. Second and 8. Ball on the 44-yard line. Texas El Paso is up 4. Zips it to the back. Tackle made at the 50.
Joseph with the tackle at the 50-yard line.
That'll make it 3rd and 1. Right lion, right lion.
Going to be stopped short. And he's tackled after positive yardage. Good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, Brad, the tailback took the pitch and picked up a few yards there on the option.
From the 47-yard line. First down. Play fake. And he just gets rid of it.
Brad, I just think this quarterback's got to do a much better job of being able to read that defense and make quicker decisions. And especially when the defense starts to get pressure, you've got to either get rid of that football or check it down.
We did.
Or take off and run with it.
He lets it go.
God, this man.
They'll bring him down around the 10-yard line.
Absolute unit.
Now it's first and 10 with a defense trying to regroup after giving up the big pass. He gets out to about the 9-yard line. This is the 8th play of this drive. Texas El Paso is up by 4. And a nice move to finish it off. Touchdown.
Oh, yeah.
And he adds the extra point. A nice 8th play, 59-yard drive. And the result, 7 points. The score now, 28-17. Ramos looks ready to kick this one off. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 21. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive.
Black 5.
30. And he's taken down at the 44. Him up 6 yards with a catch. They're about 4 yards away here on second down.
No.
Too bad that'll go down as an incompletion because he made a really great play on the ball to make the catch.
Receiver, and it's incomplete. Looks like they've decided to go for it here. Just under three to go in regulation. Quick pass. Here he goes. He's at the 20. Touchdown saving tackle, but it leaves him with a first and goal. Here they go, first and goal, down by a couple of possessions.
Ooh, I don't know how that happened.
He had nowhere to go on that option play.
Boy, you're right. He's lucky he held onto the football there.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Try for the two-point conversion. He's got it for two. They get ready to kick this one off, and the return team's looking for the onside. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. UTEP's expertise carrying the football is what we thought was going to be in the spotlight today, and here it's been the passing game instead.
Yeah, we really thought this running back would have one of those days you'd remember for a long time, but this passing game has stepped up and been put this offense in a position to be able to win this game.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Gains his way to the 33-yard line. A nice job by the offensive line, and they pick up a gain of 8. Northwestern's going to take their first time out of the half. So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Just under two to go in the game. Gets to about the 34-yard line. Hankins gets about a yard on the play. Northwestern's going to have to use their second time out of the half. And out come the big hefties. He makes it to the 35-yard line.
I think the defense put everything into that sequence of plays, and for the offense to come up with a first down really is demoralizing for the defense.
From their own 35-yard line, first down. Nice run, and he's brought down.
Dead.
It's third and 8. Ball on their own 38. Well, a lot of frustration by that offense, but you've got to give the defense credit for coming up with a stop in this quarter in a game this close.
I
comes to an end. Our final count in this game, Texas El Paso 28, Northwestern 25.
No ranking. What? Ooh, ECU's back in the top 25. Trash. Ooh, they think we're gonna be real good up there. Whoa, they got Merck.